So good morning, my dear students. Today we will be doing one of the writing skills, that is report writing. You do it very, very carefully because next week you have a competition also in which you are supposed to write down a report on corona and on the plight of farmers. These topics are given to you. So while doing report, you have to keep so many points in your mind. There are so many things so many points in your mind that you are supposed to keep in your mind, okay? And it is a part of your syllabus. It can be asked in your exams also. There are two kinds of report. One report that we read in newspapers. You open any kind of newspaper, you will come to know that on that place, on this place, one accident happened like that. How many people got injured? How many got killed? How many got died? Okay, FIR has been launched. So such kind of information we come to know about accident reports through the newspaper. But such kind of newspaper report we will be doing later on. Today we are going to do a report writing that is for magazine, that is to be published in magazine. Suppose any of the event or any of the incident happened and you are given a duty by the school to write down a report for the school magazine. Okay, so how you are going to frame a report? For example, there was any competition, there was any activity, there was annual function or any kind of organization, any kind of competition, any kind of activity, house show, what was there? So you are supposed to write down a report on that. So there is a very hard and fast rules and regulations that you have to follow while writing a report. See, first of all, keep this thing in your mind that report writing, it is a factual piece of writing. Factual piece of writing, what is that? Factual piece of writing means your piece of writing, what you are going to suppose to write, then all the things will be based on the facts. What you are seeing in front of you, you have witnessed, you have jotted down all the points, and all the points you are going to arrange in a systematical order. So whatever the facts, whatever is the reality, you are going to write down on the facts. Okay, so the first point that you have to keep in your mind, that is the factual piece of writing. Okay, clear? So here I'm going to discuss format with you. You just write down format of report writing. All the things I will be telling you, because here you are supposed to write down your name because you are the writer of this report. Okay, how will you frame all the paragraphs, what to be written in the beginning and all the things I will be telling you step by step in detail. But first of all, whatever I have told you, that report writing is a factual piece of writing. Whatever you are seeing in front of you, you are supposed to write down on this. Okay? So whatever you have witnessed, so give a suitable, catchy heading to that. Whatever the event happened in front of you, think about that, about a catchy word. A word that can catch reader's attention. Okay? So this heading, this title or this heading, this title or this caption, you can say, it should be written using capital letters. Very first rule. And four participants from 9th A and four participants from 9th B, those who are going to participate in this report writing competition, they listen it. Others also listen carefully. It is a part of your syllabus. But those who are going to participate, they also listen it very, very carefully. So when you are supposed to write down the title of report writing, that should be written in capital letters. It should be catchy enough. It should be catchy. It means it should catch readers' attention. Clear? It should catch readers' attention. And it should be not too long, okay? It should be brief. Be brief, precise. अटेंशन सीकर, अटेंशन सीकर. इट मीन्स इफ एनी ऑफ यू रीड दैट हेडिंग और टाइटल, इट शुड बी कैची, इट शुड रीड एक्चुअल्स रीडर्स अटेंशन, इट शुड बी ब्रीफ टू द पॉइंट इन नटशेल, इट शुड बी डिस्क्राइब्ड एंड इट शुड कैच द अटेंशन ऑफ द रीडर. सो सच काइंड ऑफ कैप्शन शुड बी रिटन. आफ्टर दैट वी हैव बायलाइन. सी व्हाट इज बेसिकली बायलाइन. सी यू सपोज आई गिव यू ड्यूटी that there is one show which is going on, so you just make a report on that. You sit in front of, sit by the side of stage, you look the whole program, what is going on the stage, you just bache make a report, and this report will be published in your school magazine. It can be published in newspaper also next week. So you have to make a report, which incident happened, which event took place, how it was conducted, what did principal ma'am say, how did it get concluded, okay, so all the things. So who will be the writer? You, because you have witnessed this, you have seen this, all the information will be written on the basis of facts. So here in byline you are supposed to write down your name and your class, okay? So write down byline. When you are going to write down byline, so here don't put brackets etc. hyphen, like by, suppose your name is Charvi, by Charvi, comma 9D, okay, by Nitya, comma 9A. So many students are in the habit of putting these hyphens, avoid it. So many students are in the habit of putting these brackets. Avoid it. Avoid it. Simply by your name and your class. See, bache, for writing this correct format, you are going to score 2 marks for that. Because in your writing skill, when any of the writing skill is asked, so it is written like 2 plus 3 plus 2, 7 marks. So do you know 2 marks are for what in report writing? 2 marks are for this. Only for this, writing this very, very carefully. And still students commit so many mistakes while writing this. Bache, you should not commit mistake. You should write down heading, title, caption using capital letters. It should be catchy. It should be to the point. It should be brief. Okay, precise, it should be attention seeker, and after that you are supposed to write down by line. Okay, you are supposed to write down by line. In by, write down by line by, then write down your name and your class. Your name, comma, class. Clear? So after that, each and every line of the report should be written along with the margin. Each and every. Some students are in the habit that when their report comes to an end, at last they write down their name as they are doing diary entry or any some other piece, as they are doing informal letter writing, formal letter writing. Bache, it is not like that. You have written your name here, so there is no need to repeat your name again at the last. In the beginning, you will be writing only heading, then byline. And at last, after that, you have to frame different paragraphs. Only this much comes in the category of format. If you write down these things carefully, you are supposed to get 2 marks. Am I clear to you? So what to be written in first paragraph? Okay, so that is known as introduction. Introduction, or you can say opening paragraph. Now see, you have been given a task to write down a report on any of the topic. You have witnessed that Earth Day is being celebrated, and you have seen that function, and you made a report. But your report will be only on the basis of facts. You are not write down on your own on the facts that what incident took place in front of you, what did the student do, what did the teacher do, how the activity took place, what were the things which were included in that activity, how did it start, how did it end, who participated, who got the prize, like that, all the details you have to write down. But for that, opening paragraph, introduction should be very much, you can say, in nutshell, in short, having 2-3 lines, but these 2-3 lines should be written very, very smart. So now listen carefully that it should give the information of reporter's name. Okay, what should be added in the opening paragraph? In opening paragraph, sorry, reporter's name we have written. In introduction, you have to simply describe these things. What happened? Where happened? When happened? It means what activity was conducted, where it was conducted, and when it was conducted. This line should be framed so smartly that all this information, what, where, and when, should be included only in single line. Clear? For example, Earth Day was celebrated in the school premises last week with great pomp and show. Pre-plantation Day was celebrated with lots of fervor and enthusiasm in school campus on 25th July, like this. Okay, so what, where, and when this information should be, okay, explained. What happened, when happened, where happened, and how it was conducted. It was conducted in a simple way, or with fervor or enthusiasm, or with great pomp and show. How? So these 4 points to be included in the paragraph of introduction. So bachche, write down in your notebooks this thing. Okay, you can also one line that how did the event begin? 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 So only this information should be included in first paragraph. Bachche, you are supposed to write down all the things in your fair notebook. This these notes will be checked thoroughly by me. So write down report writing format very, very carefully. Daljeet and Dhirin, they are raising their hand. Bachche, yes, Daljeet, what do you want to ask?
Ma'am, can we use personal pronouns or not?
No, I will be telling you these things also in detail. We are not supposed to write down personal pronoun because when I checked your report writing, you sent me on WhatsApp, you have used so many pronouns there. So that's why I told you that you just listen the lecture of report writing. Then you will rectify it, you will make corrections. Okay, and in this way you can do it. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Dhiren, yes, bachche, what do you want to ask?
Ma'am, I want to ask that where the line should be left, or there is a space of line.
See, there are near about 4 to 5 paragraphs you are supposed to write down in report writing. And after each paragraph, if you skip one line, so it will create good impression because it will seem very, at a glance, people will be able to understand that you have framed 5 paragraphs. So in between every paragraph, you skip one line. Clear?
And ma'am, introduction paragraph should be short or it should be a bit lengthy?
Very short, having only 2, maximum 3 lines, not more than 3. Because in this 3 lines, you have to smartly frame the line, and you are supposed to write down what happened, where happened, when, and how. So what, where, when, it can be included in one line. That Earth Day was celebrated in the school premises with great pomp and show last week. Okay, and it how did the function begin? You can frame one line on this. So having only 2-3 lines should be the part of first paragraph. Clear?
Yes, ma'am. Should we leave line after byline or before byline?
Yes, after byline you can skip one line.
Okay, ma'am.
So, बच्चे राइट डाउन ऑल द थिंग्स यू हैव टू राइट डाउन ऑल द थिंग्स इन फेयर नोटबुक सेम पॉइंट्स दैट आई हैव रिटन कॉपी लाइक सेम नाउ लेट्स मूव टू नेक्स्ट पैराग्राफ दैट इज डिटेल्स सी इन डिटेल्स व्हाट यू आर सपोज टू राइट डाउन डिटेल्स कैन बी अ वेरी लॉन्ग पैराग्राफ ओके इफ यू थिंक दिस पैराग्राफ इज टू लॉन्ग सो व्हाट डू यू डू You divide details paragraph in two parts. Detail paragraph can be divided into two parts also. But if you think, okay, one paragraph is sufficient, so that is also okay. But I will suggest you, because you are going to write down the details on the activity, actually what happened, what was the main points of the activity, how did it conduct it, how was it conducted, what were the main activities which were included in that event, how did it take place, tell about all the participants, tell about the role of a teacher, tell about which kind of skits, which kind of items were shown on the stage, okay, who stood first, second, third, who got prize, who got appreciation, which was the best item. So there are so many points, they are to be added in details. So it's better that you divide a detail paragraph also in two parts. So while writing details, what points you have to keep in your mind? Just make a list of all the things. Start writing. Okay. So, name of the activity. Name of the activity. How did it get conducted? Role of participants, teachers, overall effect, decoration, main theme of the event. Theme of the event. Okay, so there are so many things in Jalandhar Tribune you can read. So many activities are conducted nowadays, these are conducted online. So the reports of this are shown. I will be sharing it with you tomorrow. I will be showing you different kind of activities. On which different kind of reports are framed and how did it get published in Tribune. Okay, so from that you can get so many hints that the name of the activity is written, how was it conducted, what was the role of a participant, teachers, overall effect, what was that, how was the decoration, what was the theme of the event, that how did the student participate, how did the participant participate. Okay. Their role you can write down in detail. Okay. Prizes, or you can say best item. Or if there is any, you can say theme, or you can say motto of the event. Event. So you can write down all the things. Motto of the event, role of the participants, overall effect, decoration. So all the things you can write down. Okay. So bachche, jot down all the things. These are the hints that I have provided you. What points you can add in the form of detail? Yes, you can write down about speech or principal, ma'am. Yes. No, this thing I will be telling you later on. You just jot down these points. You are not supposed to write down the line on the speech of principal ma'am in this paragraph about vote of thanks, about speech, all the things you are supposed to write down in last. Yes, very good. Ridhima has given a point about guest. Who was chief guest? You can also or how did it commence? How did it commence? Commence means how did it get start? Like our annual function last to last time, it got started with Saraswati Vandana, or it got started with Ganesh Vandana, like that. So you can add up these lines, that how did the function get start? Yes, Renuka, what do you want to ask me?
Good morning, ma'am. Ma'am, in the activity of report writing, ma'am, is there any word limit?
Not word meaning, but you are supposed to write down good vocabulary words.
No, ma'am, word limit.
Word limit. Word limit.
Word limit.
Word limit is near about 150 words. Near about 150 words, not more than that and not less than that. Near about 150 words.
Okay.
Last point, I have written prizes or best items. Prizes or best items. So if you have written this, shall I move further? If you have written this, shall I move further? Okay. So that is now last paragraph, that is a concluding paragraph. So conclusion. Now, bachche, listen, what you are supposed to write down in conclusion, that paragraph should not be too long. It should be short. It should be short. Okay. So in this, you just write down how did the program get concluded. Vote of thanks. Definitely, who would be representing vote of thanks? It would be represented by Principal Ma'am. Principal Ma'am. So you are supposed to write down vote of thanks. That was done by Principal Ma'am. Okay. And the impact of the program on the audience. Impact of the program on the audience. Sometimes it's happened that there is a very touching program and audience, they feel so thrilled. They feel so, you can say, moved to watch such kind of programs. Or there is a very, you can say, long-lasting effect, impact on the audience. So such kind of nice lines you can pick up and you can write down about the impact of the program on the audience. I just want to tell you, today I forgot to plan about this thing. It is my mistake, because whenever I used to do report writing in class 7th and 8th, last to last year, before starting this topic, report writing, I used to give them a homework. Okay, so what was that homework? I used to give them a homework that just go through any kind of newspaper. It can be Hindustan Times, it can be Tribune or Indian Express. That you cut the cuttings of that where that report writing is given. That suppose any of the incident took place. But nowadays, if you read the newspaper, you will come to know that all the things are taking place virtual, online. Even online competitions are going on, online events are going on. People are conducting it on Zoom platform. Okay. So nowadays, for last 1.5 years, the trend has been changed. But earlier, there were so many news you could find out easily about report writing. Nowadays, you can also find out, but these are all only or virtual. So we will be doing practice of virtual activity also. Okay. We will be making a report on this. But first of all, I just want that you should go according to your paper syllabus, what kind of question can be asked. Okay, we will be doing virtual also, and I will be giving you so many, you can say, examples. I will be showing you those pics. I will be sharing it with you. Okay, I'll bring it tomorrow. So I used to give the homework to my student to cut that any kind of report from the newspaper and paste it in their fair notebook. You know what was the benefit of that? I used to call them again one by one and they used to read it. In this way, we had a plenty of ideas that how the reports get published in the newspaper. Actually, it is in a trend. It is going on. You can open newspaper, suppose in your city, in your surrounding, any of the activities taking place. How will you come to know? From newspaper, all the things are properly arranged in a systematical way. In the beginning, it is written what was the activity, how did it get conducted, where was it conducted, when it was conducted. And after that, you will come to know about all the details. What was that activity? Who were the participants? Who participated? Okay, and at the last, you will come to know the impact of, the effect of that activity on the audience. Okay? So this thing we can also do, but nowadays in today's newspaper, I think it is very difficult to find out this report. You will be getting reports on virtual activities. Okay, if you want, you can collect that and paste in your notebook. But I will bring so many news tomorrow. You also bring from your house, you bring the cutting, you show it on the screen. We will be discussing it tomorrow in detail. Okay, now three students are raising their hands. Let me take their doubts. Okay, Dhiren, your doubt, Pranay, your doubt, and Renuka, your.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, in newspaper, I've read the reports in newspaper, and after writing the reports, the name is written at the end. So, why the name is at the end in the newspaper?
If it is given in the end, it is okay, but you follow this method, okay, because you are going to learn it from the examination point of view also. So, whatever the points I have today told you, whatever the format I have told you today, you follow that format, then you write the name of the activity, how it is, what, where, when, and how. What, where, when, and how, these four things you are supposed to write down in first paragraph. And only one line you just frame of how did it get conducted. All the details in second paragraph, because sometime in newspaper you are not supposed to get three paragraphs. It is given in a single paragraph. Because they are supposed to frame very short report. But you are supposed to frame a report on 150 words. You have to frame three paragraphs in a systematic way. Okay? So, bachche, you frame three
okay, ma'am.
In a systematic way. The format that I have told you, follow that format for your exam. Clear? Still, if you have any doubt, you can ask me, you can raise your hand so that I can take one example and I can start teaching you that example. One of the students has written that activity ended with the national anthem. Yes, you can also write down. But you just frame, you just put two, three good vocabulary words in your report. I will be telling you when we will be doing practice. Let's take one example. You do in your rough notebook. Suppose, okay. Now, favorite party took place last week. Favorite party took place. Okay. Suppose you are a student of 12th. Okay. You have attended that favorite party, which was conducted on Zoom platform. Which was conducted on. One of the students is writing Ridhima, that we can also write on the yesterday topic by NEP by Mr. Modi. Basically, that was a seminar. No, there is, because there will be a lot of content. Lot of, we have to follow by. I just want to give you easy one, then we will be doing on the speech of NEP program of that Mr. Modi. We will be doing later on. So suppose you are a student of 12th class, you have seen farewell party, okay? It was conducted on Zoom platform, okay? So which lines you are going to frame? Hurry up. Let me see you, which lines you are going to frame. So first of all, frame first line, very beginning, very first line, what you are supposed to write down. Very first line. very first line what you are supposed to write down. What caption you have given. Okay, type your caption in chat box. For favorite party, which caption would you give? Let me appreciate the students, those who are writing caption title of the report. Hurry up, type in chat box. What title is coming in your mind? Okay, Titiksha has written farewell of 2021-22. Okay, the day of farewell is written by Aparan. Good efforts. I want best one. Okay, Daljeet has written virtual farewell. That is also awesome one. Okay, Daljeet has written virtual. Jasleen has written after party. No. Brijesh has written farewell. Okay, annual spellings are written wrong. Online farewell. Okay, so what will be the byline? What will be the byline? Now type byline in chat box. Ikjot has written very nice annual of Alma Mater. Very good. Ikjot has written the best one. Very nice. Okay, what will be the byline? By your name, like by Arzu 9A, by the rain 9A. Okay, so in this way you can frame by ABC 12B. So this is the byline you can frame. Now let's start framing first paragraph. Dhiren has written happened. Happened is not a correct word for that. It means the farewell party was organized or it took place or so all of you start framing first paragraph and raise your hand those who are quite confident that their first paragraph is ready. Hurry up. Who is going to read first paragraph? Who is going to read first paragraph? The question is that suppose virtual farewell party was organized and you are a student of 12th, you are supposed to frame report writing on this. Okay, Brijesh, can you read this? Brijesh, from 8D. Okay, Brijesh, I'm unmuting you. You just tell me what you have written. Yes, Brijesh. Done paragraph you have sent me. Okay, Titiksha, you read.
On 28/7/2021. Saturday, a colorful and memorable virtual farewell was organized with a batch of pass-out students in 2021. This event was held virtually on Google Meet, on Zoom platform, and it was conducted for almost 1.5 hours. Entire event was managed by the seventh semester students. The event commenced by the welcome speech given by Principal ma'am. This was followed by Medallia's anthem, sorry, school shabad. Then after that, students prepared dance for the plus one students prepared dance for the students of plus two.
I told you to read only first paragraph, only first. Details we will be discussing afterwards. You are supposed to write down first paragraph. Beta, we are running out of time. Only 2 minutes are left. Okay. So I think report writing concept is very much clear to you. Ninth D, have you done it before in your class? Have you done it before? No. So that's really good that I have taken report writing to be taught in 9th A and 9th B. So in both the classes, it is done. Okay, so this homework I'm giving you, you just do this homework, okay, and follow all the guidelines, follow all the points that I have discussed with you. Still, if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Okay, bachche, now I have to over this class because we have discussed a lot and time is running out. Okay, students, thank you and have a nice day.